गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. एस्टरडे आई एक्सप्लेन फर्स्ट फोर स्टेंजा ऑफ द पोएम चिल्ड्रन ऑफ द रेनबो. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग न्यू स्टेंजा आई रिमाइंड यू दैट इन दिस पोएम देयर इज अ गर्ल हुज कलर इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अदर्स. सो The children teased her and did not allow her to play with them. But the narrator likes her. It doesn't matter for her that what color of her skin is. She thinks that she is the nicest girl among all of her friend whom she met. So in these lines, that is the fifth stanza of the poem, that children are life's rainbow, black and yellow, red and white, but the colors aren't what matter, it is what down deep inside. In these lines, grandmother said that the children are life's rainbow because she believed that all children are beautiful in every way, no matter the color of their skin, whether they are black or white, and from where they belong. Children brings joy in our life just like a rainbow. Here the grandmother told the narrator that it is not important that what the color of the skin of a person. It is important that what qualities they have inside them. Students, when there is a rainbow in the sky, it looks beautiful. Why it looks beautiful? Because of the color which it has inside it. And it gives us joy. In the same way, children are beautiful, whether they are from any race, any color. They bring happiness in our life. The inner beauty is important for a person. The last stanza, I asked her if that is what it means when we say we are colorblind. She smiled and said it should mean that in all hearts and in all minds. In this last stanza of the poem, the narrator asked to her grandmother that what is the meaning of colorblind. Students, colorblind means usually unable to differentiate between two or more primary colors. Here, grandmother said that we should colorblind in our hearts and mind. This means that the color of a person's skin should not affect our feeling towards them. We should look at the inner beauty of that person. It means that we should not discriminate on the basis of race. So, student, I think that You understood it clearly. Now I am giving you a few words and you have to write the meaning of those words. Here are the words: taste, frown, colorblind, and matter. Student, you find these words, then you write the meaning, then you can write the meaning of these words in your rough copy. Tomorrow, I am going to write question answer of the chapter. Thank you.